Everybody, my name is Chad, and today I have a really fun doll review for you. So, in honor of Pixar Fest, which I believe is ending next month, I'm going to have to double check that, but for Pixar Fest, I'm going to be reviewing this Disney Animator Collection Boo from Monsters, Inc. So, the Disney Animators Collection, in case you don't know, is where they take all these Disney characters, like the Disney princesses and Tinkerbell and Alice in Wonderland, and they turn them into toddlers. And they have the large, like, baby doll size version, and then they have these little, like 4-inch size version. Now, I don't really collect this particular collection, mainly because I like the full-size, like, 12-inch dolls for the Disney princesses and everything, but Boo is a toddler already, so this is literally her size. This is perfect to add to my collection, and she is to scale based from the movie, so I just had to have her. I did get this from Disneyland from the last trip that I took in April when Pixar Fest was beginning, and I know I'm late. It's taken me a while to do this review. I've also, it's been a while since I've done a video on my channel as well, so I do apologize for that for the people who have been sending me those messages saying, when's the next video coming out? So here it is. Anyway, so back to the review. I really like the collection. I think it's super adorable, but I think they did a really, really good job at capturing Boo's likeness. I think that it really looks like the character from the movie. Also in this, it comes with her little stuffed animal, one-eyed monster, and it comes with a glittery Mike Wazowski. All of the animator collection comes in this, like, plastic carrying case, which I think is really cute. It's also really nice because, you know, for, like, little kids that want to get this, like, if you get it for them in the park, they can get it, they can play with it, and then they can put it in this box to carry it around or to, you know, put it in the stroller or their backpack or something, to keep everything in order so they don't lose all the, like, little pieces and stuff. I really like the theming because each box is unique to the character that it's for. So this one, it is purple, and then, like, the top, the handle, it looks like the top of the doors with the little indicator light from the Monsters, Inc. movie. So I thought that was a really cute idea. They have this little card here. It just says mini doll playset. So they are, like, a little playset. Oh, yeah, and it comes with her door back here. And then on the inside, it has some information here. So let me see if I can get this up closer so you can see it. So it's got a picture of Mike Wazowski. It says, Mike's arms move. And then it says, celebrating the heritage of Disney's animation with the Disney Animators Collection, created under the guidance of the Walt Disney Animation Studio and Pixar Animation Studios, most renowned animators and designers. These young renditions of your favorite characters are brought to life with creativity and imagination. So, and then this is, of course, ages 3 and up, just because it does have small parts and they don't want the little kids to put it in their mouth and choke or something. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get her out of the package and then we'll take a closer look here. Alright, so here she is out of the box. So, a couple things I wanted to show you first. So, we have her little stuffed, like, teddy bear, monster teddy bear. It is covered in glitter and the glitter is getting everywhere. But this is so cute. So it's got 4 little legs. That's so funny. And 1 eye with horn. But this is adorable. Also, she comes with holding a crayon, and I'll show you that in a second. But it comes with this little plastic. It's supposed to be the picture that she drew for Sully, of her and Sully. And I had a little mishap here while trying to get this out of the box. So be very careful because this is just a sticker that's on the front of this piece of plastic here. And I kind of messed it up a little bit, but that's okay. It's still, you can still tell what it's supposed to be. Next, I wanted to show you the door. So this is, like, where the playset part comes into place. You got the side that is just the door and then the other side that has, like, the flowers on it. And it actually opens. It opens all the way, so that way she can go through the door, and it does click closed. so that way it can stay closed. So I'm just going to leave it open there. Oops. And next is Mike Wazowski, and he is completely covered in glitter as well. And he is so cute, even though he looks like he's trying to scare you. He's just too adorable. He's not scary at all. But he's got this button in the back here where when you press it, his arms move. So he could be like, rah, rah, rah. But I just thought that was really cute. It also comes with his work hat, his little hard hat here that has the Monsters, Inc. logo on the front. And this just pops right on his head just like that. So he looks super cute. When I put the hat on, it does push the button down, so it did move his hands down automatically, so the hands are out of the way. But I just thought that was kind of cute, so he can sit there with his hat. And now, let's go and take a look at Boo. So, this is the crayon I was telling you about. The crayon. How do you pronounce it where you're at? Do you say crayon or do you say crayon? I usually say crayon. I don't know. It's like a mixture between the two. But anyway, so she's got this little purple crayon here that she uses. So you can play like she's coloring, which I think is really cute. She's got her little outfit here, just like in the movie, this long pink t-shirt, her little purple tights, and just her little socks here, which are actual socks that are fabric that are on, which are really cute. She's got her hair up in this little pigtails. Her hair is very gelled, but the feel of it seems to be a pretty decent grade of hair, which is nice. But it is gelled into place, which is fine because I really like rooted hair on dolls, but for this style, having it gelled makes sense, so it actually looks like it did in the movie. But it's got these little, what do you want to call these, hair elastics with the beads on them, just like she did in the movie. And she has a really, really cute face, and I think they did a really good job at painting these. I don't really see any factory defects or anything like that, but I think she's so cute. I love this expression that she has. Now, this doll has 7 points of articulation. So she has the basic 5 points where she can move and turn her head. She can rotate and lift and move her arms, and then also her hips can rotate, and she can sit down, but also her knees bend as well. So that's actually really cute. So you can sit her down and bend her knees, and she can like sit on a chair or something. So I just thought that was a cute little touch. I always like the more articulation you can put in a doll, the better. And these dolls are pretty short. They're about, I want to say 4 inches or close to about 4 inches tall. And for a doll this small to have that much articulation is actually kind of nice. And she feels like a very, very good quality. I mean, it comes from the Disney store, and the Disney store dolls tend to have really good quality as well. So overall, I am super excited to add her to my collection, especially since she's the perfect scale to fit with my other Disney dolls, because this is how tall she really would be compared to, or next, standing next to, like the Disney princesses. So, but I'm really happy to add her to my collection. I love Boo. I think she's an adorable character. I love the Monsters, Inc. movies, and I really, really love the Monsters, Inc. ride at California Adventure. If you haven't been to it, I highly recommend it. But anyway, so yeah, like I said at the beginning of the video, I wanted to do this particular doll review for Pixar Fest. It is still going on at the time of me recording this video, so if you're able to make it to Pixar Fest, I highly, highly recommend it, just because they have some really cool things going on. The Incredicoaster just opened up. They have some new food things going on, all in California Adventure, and then of course they have the parades. Paint the Night is back, and the Pixar Fest fireworks show is amazing, and I have to say, I think it is the best fireworks show that Disneyland has come up with. Anyway, that's all I have for you for this doll review. Thank you so much for watching. If you like it, just let me know by hitting that thumbs up. It's really easy. It's free. Doesn't cost anything. Also, if you want to see more doll reviews like this, let me know by subscribing and also commenting down below, and let me know what other dolls you would like to see me do a review for. Anyway, that's all I've got for you today, but thanks so much for watching again. I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye.